Boy, got a check. Drip too hard, made it. I know she won't forget that we met. She hit her, broke it down, she a wreck. They saying more, you better than the rest. Who, me? I never would've guessed. Ricky, but I do it like a vet.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
Had to take the stairs to the top floor. Top. Every that slept been done for. Got a few bands, need a ton more. If we empty out the that's a drum roll. If we move five, hit him with the 100 strikes. Now that me like a real. Hold on, let me catch my breath. Hold on, let me catch my breath. We getting to the bread, it was crumbs. She love God, turn nothing into something. She let me knock it out of the park, home run. I'm a giant bear bun. She told me that the money make a. She tried more than the mother. Ain't nothing, ain't nothing. I've been always feeling like the one. These other, I'ma show 'em how it's done.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
I'm getting opinions from so many folks. I bring the horses to keep getting the love from my state.
What do I do
to keep the money coming in?
What do I do?
Writing until I need another pen.
Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last.
People view everything different when you touching on the back.
What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and hitters, man.
You can never be except you carry, gotta wear a mask.
They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, Papa, I'm trying to change you.
I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging.
All in all, we have a pretty pleasant December day in the Volunteer State. The chilly rain from last night has moved on. The temps have bumped up a bit here at Nissan Stadium in Nashville. The whole of downtown Nashville, Lakeland still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with the Dallas Cowboys. Taking in at the three. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Time for Tony Pollard, and he'll take this one up to about the 23. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
This defense for the Titans, they were excellent a week ago in that victory over Indianapolis.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down, and they're playing with extreme confidence.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And he'll get this one up to the 26. An early task, 2 plays in, this is 3rd and 2. Prescott. He'll have a first down, past the 40. Look at the big man rumble! Touchdown, Cowboys! A great play there! His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead.
I tell you, for a defender, that's got to be a scary sight, seeing a big man like this with a head of steam behind him as he makes that catch and then turns upfield.
Yeah, normally when you talk about tight ends, you immediately begin talking about them rumbling down the field. But to me, he was pretty well gliding downfield there. Very athletic for a big man. It takes this one all the way to pay dirt.
Get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Tannehill and the Titans come up now 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And that will be off target and incomplete.
And CD, you look at this defense, you know, what kind of pressure are they under trying to stop a team that has won 5 games in a row?
Well, to me, it makes their job harder because you know you're going up against an offense that's playing at an elite level. And sometimes you can get too caught up in trying to play the perfect game. You're trying to be too precise, too fine, instead of just letting it rip. And I think that's more the priority than trying to be absolutely perfect.
Brown has the first down and much more. And he'll take it to the 43-yard line.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Go! Tiger!
Now a first carry for Derek Emery. And a good burst there gets him seven up to midfield. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead him to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Kill, kill, kill. Turn up. Kill, kill, kill. Turn up.
Henry again on second down. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
First look now for Darrington Evans. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Ladies! Turn right.
Throwing quickly, that's caught by Brown out wide. Midway point of this first quarter.
Let's go, right. Hey, let's get there. Hey, check 24.
Tannehill on first down. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. Tannehill. And that nearly an interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes with a big third down coming up. He's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
Throwing on third down, Tannehill. Looking left side, he's got it complete. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, Tannehill. Man in stride, complete, and into the end zone for Tennessee touchdown. Jesse James. His first touchdown on the year. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point up and good by Roman. And a tail score in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Taken in at the three. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time too.
Had to sit on there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Prescott down. Letting one fly deep for Cooper. That's caught at the 25. Touchdown, Cowboys. Amari Cooper, 79 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. But Dak Prescott, probably not the first name you think of in terms of strongest arms in the NFL, but he showed it off there. Extra point by McCann, up and good, and that makes the score 14-7.
Tucker McCann set to kick off.
McCann's got it teed up. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Titans offense set to begin the drive. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters box like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something, because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line.
You think you're going to get this? Show it up. Show it up. Switch, switch.
Go, go.
Tannehill. Incomplete. Well, that's a perfect example of how he was named NFC Defensive Player of the Week from last week's game. He is just all around the football right now, isn't he?
That he is, and it's funny because I talked with the coaching staff about drills that they do in practice, and one of them is called matching hands. And as soon as that hand is launched by the quarterback, you throw up the opposite hand and match that hand with the QB, and oftentimes you're able to knock it away, as we just saw there.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. From the gun, here's Tannehill. Got his man, that's the Pro Bowler Julio Jones. And take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot and they connected there and picked up a first down.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop it behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Second down, they go again with Henry. And they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
From the gun on third down, Tannehill throwing the out route incomplete. It's Brown. And I think the ball's out. And it's picked up by the Cowboys. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. These defenses have become so opportunistic, and no matter what you're playing, in this case, wide receiver, you got to be careful.
Certainly do.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
This would have been a 54-yard boot had they tried a field goal, but they will not try a field goal. They're going for it. They'll run for it with Henry. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Thought they might throw the football with a little chunk that they had remaining on fourth down, but they ran it. They got it.
And the reason they were able to get it done, he ran that play with conviction, didn't he? Understood he would get a little bit of help from his friends up front, but it was really on him to go ahead and make the power move and get it done, and that he did.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now it's Tannehill. Man open, here's Jones. And it's a Titans touchdown. Julio Jones with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Pulling good on the extra point. And they will tie our score with this opening quarter of play. Taking in at the 3. And he will be taken down here as the first quarter of play will come to an end. These two teams all tied after 1. 14-14. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that could help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Second down and 5. They'll run left with Pollard. Dancing. dancing away at the 35. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
Good work, boy. Let's go.
These are relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Prescott. Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring it down. Jaron Reed muscles his way in for the sack.
But that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face. Not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. Oh, tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point up and good by Bella. And the lead is now 21-14. Seems to get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning them for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that, because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle. You know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here. The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. It'll be a handoff to Pollard, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
I thought he did a nice job there setting an edge and make sure nothing could get to the outside, but he decided that wasn't enough for him. Worked his way back inside and made the tackle on the ball carrier.
To the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points,
another pressure, he's gonna go down to the hillside. Micah Parsons in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him. If you want a lesson on how to defeat an offensive tackle, that was pretty textbook.
Is that a clip and save?
Yes.
That's what's going to go around the league, and people are going to watch that and say, my goodness, that's how you do it. And I feel awful for the offensive tackle, because we always talk about the athleticism of that guy who just beat him. Well, you have to be athletic to try and block that guy. Just in this case, the defense won.
pushing through the contact. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Got exactly what they wanted there out of the RPO and had the defense out of position.
One word for you there. Excellent. Because he read all the keys properly, made the right decision, and look at the result. Pretty substantial gain.
From the 45 on second down, Tannehill. And a man into the hands of his receiver. That's a first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 33.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10, down at the 33. Back to throw, Tannehill. Again, he finds Moore. And they'll have it in the run zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down back at the 26-yard line. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down.
Remember, they had the nice gain on the previous play, but they just gave a lot of it back right there on that sack.
Yeah, they get the sack, get back some real estate. Felt like the type of play that could spark a defense and swing some momentum. Almost felt like a take that type of a play, didn't it, partner?
Go, go. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line.
Chauncey Gardner-Johnson on the tackle. Brings up third down.
The Titans on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 16. Now Tannehill. It's complete to Jones. And the ball is out. Jones got hit and lost it. It's picked up by the Cowboys. Is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys.
And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right.
They don't want it, boys.
Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. They'll run. It's Henry. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. Just enough push up front. He only needed about 6 inches. He didn't get a whole lot more than that.
No, but he
made sure he got enough so they didn't have to worry about measuring it or making it even close. Ends up picking up a couple of yards in a situation, as you noted, where he only needed inches.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. They'll run here with Evans. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Darrington Evans, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Titans are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Bullock good on the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. Send this one away after the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And if I we kept having a rough patch, he said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Prescott looks to throw on first. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. So no gain on the play. And it'll be second and 10.
That's a nice job defensively to make sure everyone was accounted for, because ordinarily you pick up the guys downfield and sometimes you forget about the running back. In this case, they did not and dropped him for no gain.
Here's second and 10. Prescott from the gun. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
And let's face it, you could put any Halloween costume on him, you're not going to be able to disguise him, because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, trying to work his way back to his left, which is a minimal gain as the defense is able to react quickly.
That ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Oh, pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least it'll be fourth down. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and 5. They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. Oh, Prescott stripped. It's picked up by the Titans. Does the big boy have the juice? And they're going to bring this one back. A fire return touchdown for the Titans. This first half has been a nightmare. The offense defense just died.
And when you're picking up the ball, picking up their mistakes, and taking it the other way and putting it in the end zone, that's a defense's dream. They're having that type of a game.
Everything that can go wrong has gone wrong for this offensive unit. Extra point and good by Bullock. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. A first down throw for Prescott. And that nearly a turn. incomplete. Well, fortunate to retain possession there. It's second down.
I know that interception was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game, and I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, all the defensive guys have been talking about is, we kept this guy right where we wanted. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a challenge, and it missed a golden opportunity.
And this time, he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. A chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. McCann's kick up and good. And the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. Well, not the best first half facing this deficit, but at least they did put three on the board before half.
Yeah, it's a little bit like that stormy, cloudy day, and the sun peeks through just for a second. They saw the sun there. They're hoping to see a little bit more of it in the second half.
It's a squibber picked up around the 27. So we've reached halftime here in Nashville, the Music City, with the Titans out in front. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. McCann's got it teed up. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
Behind the chain, second and 13.
Ready? Tight ends Ringo. Tight ends on the Ringo. Tight ends on the Ringo. Hey. Four down, four down, four down.
A shotgun snap for Tannehill. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
I like what they did there, because many of the deep throws we see in the course of a game come to the outside, the perimeter of the field. In this case, they used a slot receiver to run deep downfield and tried to connect that way. Unsuccessful in that attempt, but I like what they were doing.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun, Tannehill. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. They'll get 11. is Matt Bosher now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. Now, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Then he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play holding them to no gain.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. On play action, Prescott. And he's going to go down. It is a 5-yard line. It's a sack. Jaron Reed, his second sack of the night.
Here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. The last run got six, now second and four.
Receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they look out of the slot,
You often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way gap. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
And it's across the 40 for the extra yards to the 43. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
To throw on second and six, Prescott. And for the third time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Christian Fulton. And the Titans will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. Second straight drive now here, Charles, and have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They're just looking for more of the same. Great first half so far. Good second half. And sometimes, I guess, maybe, Charles, these coaches, they don't have to tell these guys much when they're rolling like they're rolling right now.
You're exactly right. I've heard stories of some of the best coaches in our time or any time having grabbed their staffs at halftime and said, guys, they're playing really well. Don't go in there, give them a whole lot of stuff. Just pat them on the back, and essentially the speech at halftime is, let's go, guys, and that's it.
Yeah, no one's upset the apple cart so far. Evans gets it again on second down. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that one officially a loss of one?
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great. Because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer. Instead, the tackle for the loss landed right in his lap.
On third down, Henry, and he went nowhere. He went backwards, back to the 33. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
An interesting and intriguing decision, though, defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They've got to dig down deep. Right? They need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half. Okay, because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up, yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
You think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been... Man, it's caught at the six-yard line.
Right.
And they're going to have this all the way down deep into Tennessee territory. A big play here for Dallas.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they even let you play.
Right there.
Second down and goal. Prescott. Caught on a slant. Touchdown, Cowboys. Amari Cooper with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Cowboys cut into that lead. He has his two scores, but still a sizable deficit in this game.
Do you have him in fantasy football this week?
Unfortunately, no.
It's too bad, right? That would have been big points. But he is really trying to rally his team as best he can. Things are not going as well the rest of the way for them. That's why they're down with this deficit. He might need to score a couple of more times to give them a chance.
Prescott, they're going to throw for it. And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further. He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
Titans offense set to begin the drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. Your three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up. They'll run it again with Henry. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. There's Matt Bosher now as he's on to punt for Tennessee. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. 35 yards that time on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. This has been frustrating for them to this point. They have not looked the same as they did coming in, riding that impressive six-game win streak. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. And he'll get this one up to the 26. And that time, the tackle by Malik Hooker.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
Now a throw here to his running back. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down for a nice little gain. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six. The Cowboys on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. They're up against a third and one situation. Trying to run forward with Pollard. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
Muscle damage has been done through the air. Man, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns. But guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Muscle burst right there.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Prescott to throw it. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. Jalen Reed in there to get him yet again. That is his third sack tonight. They can't figure him out. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Another try after the first down sack. Prescott looking deep in the direction of Cooper. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. I think you'd agree that looked like the right call from up here.
No doubt about it. And what everyone has to understand is that the officials are going to be right on the play each and every time. You may not like the call, but they're usually spot on.
So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Play fake. Here's Prescott. He's got his receiver, Cooper. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Now he dumps this off over the middle and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
And Charles, with that completion, I'm told that puts him now over 3,000 yards passing on the campaign.
And Brandon, I think we have to start to think about where we are in the season, because right now, 4,000 is not out of the question. I think a big game or two, he's certainly capable of getting that done.
First down, Prescott. That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Amari Cooper there to make the grab. And the Cowboys have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Extra point by McCann, up and good. And the lead is trimmed down to 10.
42, Cowboys 32.
McCann's got it teed up. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25. Draw play. This is Henry. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
The Titans on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 11. Tannehill. He's going to look deep for more. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Well, still a long way to go, but trending upward. They scored the last time out, you remember, then their defense forced the punt. Now they try to inch closer, but still ultimately down two scores in the final quarter.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least three here to get it back to a one-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle, that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try to get the ball back again.
On first and 10, Prescott. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Looking to throw, Prescott. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he's finally down at the 21-yard line. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
Do you know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in. Working with a second and 3. Prescott. Screen pass, that's complete. And that loose yard is here, knocked back to the 19-yard line. It'll be a loss of 6 yards on the play. And they're going to face a third down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And this will be incomplete. Boy, can you believe this? That one probably should have been picked too. Instead, it's fourth down.
I'm trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown. And frankly, that should have been another pick right there. McCann's got it teed up. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Titans offense set to begin the drive. Their lead back down to one score after the field goal a moment ago, so they'll be looking to string together a few first downs, likely on the ground as they begin first and 10. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line.
It's going to be a long down. Check 26, check 26. Watch the safety creep.
Tannehill going to get this forward on the jet sweep. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First down, Titans gain of 12. Just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender. Somehow, they didn't get that communicated well, and it turned into a nice play.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Four down, four down.
Hey, hey, hey.
49, check 49, check 49.
Save.
They'll try and chew some clock with Henry. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11.
Tighten up.
Tighten.
Check your hot read.
They'll keep it on the ground. Henry looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the two-minute warning, and we'll be back. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
Mike 12.
To throw is Tannehill. He's got it complete. Derrick Henry. And now here comes the third of their timeouts defensively. So they'll be left with only the two-minute warning to stop it from here on out. Here's Matt Bosher now as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken at about the 18-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And that will come the offense as they take over. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Well, the defense got its job done, forcing the punt. Now the formula pretty simple. They need to find the end zone here. A field goal doesn't help them much. And throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And he'll be out right at the 35. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Now Prescott. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Brings up second and a yard.
Here's second and a yard. There 2 yards and second and one is now third and three. Fourth quarter down to the final 2 minutes and we've got a one score game. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. And that is incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Desperation time. Prescott on fourth. That's complete to Lamb. And he's got the first down. Yardage before being taken down at midfield. Fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need. That's exactly what they got done.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential. But when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
Prescott. Can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Jeffrey Simmons in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. An important play right here, third and 10.
And now it is back pressure here.
Now Dak. And this is caught. Amari Cooper. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 21.
And this is obviously a spot where you lean on your stars. Get the ball to them in open space and let them do what they do.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the two-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
Second and 10. Here's Dak. And his ball is caught. It's a touchdown. And now in the final seconds, they're a PAT away from likely getting this thing to overtime.
Yes, sir. That touchdown puts him in striking distance. And let me tell you something. Forget being conservative here. Go for it. Go for two.
Well, going for it on the road. Want to win it right now.
Well, win it right now. Have the momentum. Go ahead and get it done.
McCann for the point after. And we may very well be heading to overtime.
That ties the game at 42-all. Tucker McCann sets the kickoff.
Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams are all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
Tannehill. Able to find Jones. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
Partner in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Watch the twist.
Tannehill to throw. Man open, here is Jones. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
Go.
So four corners wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dime. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Titans offense set to begin the drive. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line.
Switch, 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 switch.
They'll keep it on the ground. Henry, and he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 53 yards rushing for him now in the ball game, and that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Single, single, I got single in the slot, single in the slot.
First throw in overtime for Tannehill. He'll flip this out to Evans. And he will have a Titans first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on third and one.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he's watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game, that's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Tannehill with a play fake to Henry. He'll throw instead. And that is incomplete. Now the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Keeping the aggression going on defense in overtime here on first down blitz.
You know you can get burned on it big time if they pick it up, but in this situation, they brought the blitz, put some pressure on the QB, and he wasn't able to complete a pass downfield.
Check 50. Shit.
Throwing again on second and 10. Tannehill. And he comes back with one complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness is a premium for all of that now.
Two first downs, have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Here's Tannehill. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
Well, the great coach has said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Tannehill. Looking downfield for Jones. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way
tried to throw the ball to Julio Jones there. He's never considered covered. He's either too fast or too strong. You always try and get it to him.
Especially on those deep passes. In need of a 3rd-and-10 conversion to keep this opening drive of OT alive. Back to throw, Tannehill. Oh, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kelvin Joseph. And the Cowboys are going to have it with a chance to win the game here in overtime. A costly mistake here in OT.
And you know what they say when you throw an interception like that in overtime? You don't usually get a chance to throw a second one. I mean, I'm not sure the analytics on it. Let's ask Marvin, our statistician, to ring that down for us. That's typically how coaches and teams feel about it. If you throw one, you likely cost yourself the game.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Three yards remain for 2nd down. And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory.
He's across midfield for the 49-yard line. It's a gain of 2 yards, and it's 3rd down.
Timeout here called by the Titans. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. A big call here in overtime. They're going for it on 4th down. Can Prescott do in the OT? Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Well, when they kept the offense on the field, you saw the face I made looking at you like, what are they doing? How did they do that?
Yeah, that's almost a miracle, isn't it? Because the two of us have talked to play callers, and every time we talk to them about going for it on 4th and long, they give us that same look you just gave me. And they always say, I don't have that call on my play sheet, Haas. We just don't have that one. Well, apparently he did, and they got it.
And in overtime, wow. They'll run on 1st down. Pollard, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. 2nd down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Kill!
They go back to Pollard on second down. And he'll get three down to the 34-yard line.
He's tackled at the 34-yard line. A 3-yard gain on the play. Brings up the third down.
We're going to get whistles and a timeout.
Damn it.
With 3 seconds left in the extra session. So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. And we're going to get whistles and a timeout. With 3 seconds left in the extra session. Kicks of the night is forthcoming. And quite a bit of pizza in this box. It's a 53-yard attempt. And he got it. The kick is good. In overtime, he's able to split the uprights. And with that, they will move out in front by 3. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Cowboys, they continue to make their case for the playoffs as they move to 9-3. And they'll get another road date next week where they take on Washington. Meanwhile, for the Titans, this loss cost them in the playoff chase as they fall back to 7-5 on the year. And they'll be on the road next week as they get a date with the Jaguars in Jacksonville.